Good morning, guys. It's Monday morning. Lillian from Lily Ray's Collection. I'm here to share a project with you. I had to do a lot of it off camera because it takes a while to color and cut and get these things going. I didn't do the background, so we'll do that together. This is my doll that I drew out. And I just left her as a blank canvas so that I could reuse her and change her dress. I made these pumpkins. This is a Tim Holtz cat. I just colored him in. And then these are my webs. And then this is how she turned out after I colored her. So I made a hat for her, a broom, and I gave her some shoes, and I gave her some fishnet stockings. So from that, she went to that. So now we are going to do the background, and then we're going to place her on here with the pumpkin and the cat and the web and see how we can bring that together. So I want to start off with my distress inks. I don't have orange. This pumpkin was colored with an orange pencil. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the green first. And this is watercolor paper, 110 pound. So I am just going to start filling in spots. As I said, it takes a minute. And again, I'm going to do this randomly. Do the brown down here. Oh, I took the wrong one. Damn it. Oops, excuse me. I have the green too close. And I'm going to put on the yellow. Okay, now I'm gonna put some spritz of alcohol so it could be, so we could react to this. Can you see that slightly? Let's put a little more. I hope we can see that. Okay. And then I'm going to take the brown and ink my edges. Let me take this off. This size is 4x6, and this is a size that I used to make for the ladies who have planners. It can be used as a planner insert. It has been used as a planner insert for all of my planner ladies. It's been a while since I've done this. Excuse me. Just like that. Then we are going to, I want to clean this. Okay, now we can go ahead, move that aside. And again, I need my double mounting tape. Roll of this, you could get this from the dollar store. So I was mounted on chipboard, so that it's nice and sturdy. So let's see what we're gonna do here. I don't have anything planned. We have her hat, we have her, right? Let's put her hat on. Let me start gluing this stuff on. So I made a slit for her hat to fit on her head like that. So I'm going to turn her over and I'm going to use some tape just to hold that down. Okay, so now she has her hat on. And then her broom. You can kind of put it like this. Just like. Could put her broom here. Let's see. Or we can put the broom between her legs. No, because she's not holding on to the broom. So we'll just put the broom on the side of her like that. How about that? We'll do that. front, and then I want a web over here. I want a web over here, and then another web maybe over here. We have the cat. I'm going to put him behind the pumpkins. And then I have a little hat for the cat. It's a big hat for the cat. See, this takes time. Or maybe I'll put a slit in the cat's ears can stick out. How about that? Let's see if that works. I'll do it here. I'm just going to do a slit. It's hard because the item is so small. It may not work, but let's try it. Let me pause you and figure this out. Okay, I decided that I'm gonna mount her onto this cardboard, actually, not her, but the watercolor paper onto this cardboard so that it's sturdier. This is a Tim Holtz Pulley tool. So I have to get this just so that it's exact on the borders. This will just stabilize the paper. So I'm gonna go ahead and hopefully not get my head in the way. That's better. A lot better. Now I'm going to do a 3/16 punch, and the way you use this tool is this little lock unlocks by pushing it down, squeeze it, and then push it down. And then you have your centimeters on this side, inches on this side, and right there it says 1/8, and on here it says 3/16. So I want it back. I'm going to use this bigger hole. All right, and just I'm going to guesstimate the approximate center. All right. This is the only thing I don't like about this tool, that you really have to poke these things out, which is ridiculous. Now let me see. I'm gonna use a copper eyelet. And so this little knot peak right there goes on the top of this, and your base is the bottom here, and it says base right there, so that would be the bottom. So just stick it in there and squeeze. And there you go. And then to lock this, you just push it back up. And you're done. Okay. Let me just set this aside. Okay, I have... this is organza. Shiny ribbon, transparent ribbon. It works for me. Actually, I'm going to make her and her, the edges on this a little darker because it is Halloween. Let's pull that. Okay. So I pull it and then I tie it again. And then pull it back. Okay, so I'm going to take this and I'm going to take and put my black one on there. And then I know this one's almost done, so. Do a combination of the dark edges. I don't have a lot of Halloween stuff, so I have to be creative. Just like that. Framed a little better. Okay. Want to put the spider web down as a place to kind of show as though she's standing on something, not just floating in the air. I'm gonna set that down like this. And then I'm gonna take, and her broom is gonna be like that. So I'm going to take a piece of tape. Or should I put her broom behind her? Should be like that. guess we could put the broom in the back like it's sitting somewhere. She's gonna stand here on the web. Or I could put the broom as though it's on the floor, like that. Or behind her. Not sure. Okay, let me get my pumpkins. See, this is what takes the most time. I'm putting a dimensional tape on there. And then this one's gonna go right in front of that one. And then the cat is gonna be behind this pumpkin. So let's see, it's gonna be like that. Let me do it about there. Yeah. And we're gonna put the pumpkins right here. And then the little cat is gonna be about there. I hope you could see what I'm doing here. Okay. He looks like a crazy cat, but that's the idea. I want him to look like he's behind the pumpkin. Or the pumpkins. And then I am going to put the stick behind her. So I'm just going to use my double-sided tape, ATG gun. Oh, can't pull too hard. And just a little bit of glue on the stick. She's gonna go there. I'm just gonna put the stick like the broom is in the air. She's a witch, right? So the broom could most certainly be in the air. And then here, I'll put her standing there. But I definitely want to put some dimensional tape on her. For her skinny legs. Excuse me. I have bad allergies today. Let me just put it right there. We don't want the tape showing anywhere. Okay. And this one, we can put it, force to put on her shoulders and her neck. So I'm going to go ahead and take this off. Excuse me. So I want to make sure she's on her spider web. Okay. And then I'm going to add another spider web. I think I may have to do some more spider webs. I'd like to put one right here. Then I want to put one right here. Okay. Let's see if this fits. Yep. Gotta get it just so. Okay, I like that. It has a web inside. Now, I want to get this, there's a key in here. Oh, good gosh. Okay guys, what I decided to do was to punch a frame, a heart frame, around this card and also a skeleton key. I also found my eyeballs. And I'm going to put an eyeball on the spider web. If I could get this to come out. Okay, let's see. Do it right in the center. Same thing with this one. Okay, and then I want to do and actually put it on here. Let's do it this way so we can see what we're doing. Perfect. There. This has a little spider, so I just did a string coming down that the spider is holding on to its own web. All right, and the last touch is gonna be my Glimmer Homemade Shimmer Mist. And that is our card. This is, this fits a planner. I believe it's a B6 planner. I forget what the girls had, but anyway, they know. It's a size 4x6. I hope you enjoyed this, and it will be on my Etsy page. Alright guys, thank you for joining me, and take care.